oil in your engine will start to get dirty and eventually will degrade over time. So, to prevent your engine from damage, it's important that you change your oil and filter as often as required. How often you need to change your oil and filter depends on the type and style of driving that you do. If you make a lot of frequent short journeys, then you may need to change your oil a lot more than someone who makes longer, well-distance journeys. So, if you think it's time to change your oil and filter, head down to your local auto parts store and check out the range they've got available.
We're going to be under the car, meaning you'll need to jack it up and secure it with axle stands to be safe. We didn't have any jacks around, so used some car ramps. However, the low profile of the bumper made it difficult to get up. Once you're underneath, locate the oil sump. It's fairly easy to find. Position your drain tray under the sump and unscrew the bolt to release the filthy flow of used oil. The bolt will be on tight, so use a socket wrench to loosen it for you. Remember not to get used car oil on your skin as it's slightly carcinogenic. Gloves are recommended. Leaving the sump to drain, proceed to the front of your engine and unscrew the oil filter. It's in a difficult position, but with the correct size wrench, you should be fine. Once again, my super strength made it easy to release by hand. Once oil is no longer leaking from the filter socket, clean the area with an old rag. Using a dab of new oil, lube up the new filter and screw on tightly. Without forgetting to replace the screw on the oil sump, move to the engine bay and open the oil cap. Slowly pour in the new oil. This will take around 4.7 litres. Regular checks of the dipstick ensure you fill the engine to the correct level. Replace the cap and make sure it's facing upright. Changing your own oil is easy and cheap and it keeps your car running at its best. Thanks for watching this FTO Visual Owners Manual, brought to you by technikhaus and FTO New Zealand.